Imagine a fifth grader who is already bankrupt or a 16-year-old in debt for houses and cars. Thieves have a new target, and we learned tonight that 1 in 10 American children is the victim of identity theft. 1 in 10. And as ABC's Pierre Thomas tells us, it can be years before parents realize it.
Olivia McNamara was starting her freshman year at Vanderbilt University, and like so many 18-year-olds, applying for her first credit card. That's when the nightmare started. Olivia's credit applications were rejected twice. Someone had stolen her identity when she was 9 years old. They had years to run up $1.5 million in debt.
I can't even describe it. It's just really shocking, and we just had no idea.
The thieves created more than 42 accounts, defaulting on all of them.
They took loans out on boats and houses and everything.
Olivia's still working to clear her credit. It may take her months, if not years, to start fresh. A new report estimates that a staggering 1 in 10 American children are victims with no clue it's happening. Criminals hack home computers looking for tax forms with the social security numbers of children. They've also stolen identities from hospitals, child welfare agencies, even schools.
We see children who have had this crime begin at as early as age, 5 months old, and then it goes on for years.
Thieves stole 11-year-old Brianna's social security number and ran up more than $132,000 in debt, buying a car and a house. Using 8-year-old Bradley's ID, crooks took out 2 student loans and got 5 credit cards. Total damage, $19,200.
The problem is large and growing. And part of the problem is it's generally undetected and undetectable.
Undetected because thieves use false names and addresses repeatedly, simply opening new accounts after they default.
So what can parents do to protect their children? The most important thing, tell your children never to give out their social security number without your permission, and make sure you check your child's credit periodically, no matter how young.
I'm just happy that we caught it when I was 18 and not when I'm 22 and trying to get my own apartment.
Pierre Thomas, ABC News, Washington.